Hi folks, this is René Molenaar for GNS Threefold, and I want to show how you can solve the VRF routing lab. So we have two routers here and we are going to play with VRF, and the idea is that each router will have a different VRF with a couple of loopbacks in it. We're going to set up a tunnel in between and we should get EIGRP working for the VRFs. So we have full connectivity. I really like this lab because it's not that hard, but it really makes you think how VRF works. So let's see what we have to do. First of all, let's set up the VRFs and we have to add the loopback interfaces to the VRFs. So I'm going to create a VRF sulu here. And I'm going to put the loopback in the VRF. This is really annoying. You have to reconfigure your IP address. So that's the first router. Let's reconfigure the IP addresses. There we go. So we have a VRF and the loopbacks are in the VRF. Next step, configure the tunnel 1 interface, both routers. Source and destination should be from the fast Ethernet link. So the tunnel source and destination, that's from our global routing table. There we go. That should take care of the tunnel. And the tunnel 1 interface should be added to the VRF. So let's sulu on this one and check off over here. There we go. Configure the 192.168.21 subnet on the tunnel interface. There we go. And the last step, configure EIGRP, and we're going to use it to get full connectivity. And if everything is okay, we should be able to ping each other's loopback interfaces. So what you need to do is use the address family command, because we need the VRF for this one. And then just add the correct network statements. That should be it, and I think I need to add the autonomous system number here. There we go. Neighbor adjacency established. Now don't forget that if you use show IP route, you won't see anything because that's the global routing table. But if we look at the VRF, you can see that we have learned about the loopbacks from the other side. So let's ping from the VRF. And you can see that it is working. And I can try to ping from my loopbacks, which proves that router sudo also knows about the loopbacks from checkoff. And that's the end of this lab. So this is how you can set up VRF routing. I hope you enjoyed this. If so, make sure you also check out some of my other MPLS labs. For now, thanks for watching and till next time.